Hello and a very warm welcome to the fresh new episode of Students' Time, your weekly update on what is happening in the field of education, politics, economics, business, entertainment, science, technology, research and innovation. I am Ananya Katti, your host for the day. Artificial intelligence or AI is known to all and the trending debate of man versus machine is missed by none. AI is a technology widespread in every possible sector you can think of. But this technology was created by humans. And yet, we humans are always concerned about whether AI will take away our jobs or will it surpass human intelligence in the near future to an extent where technology starts controlling humans and not the other way around. Today, we will be discussing about many such questions and what impact does AI actually have on human intelligence and the society. We will discuss about the capabilities and constraints of both AI and humans and how they impact the society and try to find out if both can work together for a better world. Man versus machine. Keeping this as the base for our discussion today, I would like to introduce you to our panelists for this discussion, the third year students of School of Media and Journalism, who will be putting forth their viewpoint and opinion on the topic. Talking for AI, we have Shayonika Behra, Muskan Moolchandani, and Shirsendu Sanyal. Talking for Human Intelligence, we have Yash Soni, Mitali Annigeri, and Ketki Dani. Before diving further into the discussions, I would like to set some ground rules for our panelists. If you want to express something, talk about it, you can raise your hands. Avoid interrupting in somebody else's point. अपने कमेंट्स को थोड़ा प्रिसाइज और कंसाइज रखें ताकि हम सबकी बात सुन पाए, सबका पर्सपेक्टिव जान पाए. सो लेट्स डाइव फर्दर इनटू द डिस्कशन. आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट मुस्कान टू प्रेजेंट हर ओपनिंग स्टेटमेंट.
As Dave Waters quote, that predicting the future isn't magic, it's artificial intelligence. Researchers believe that there is 50% possibility that AI will surpass the human intelligence in the next 45 years. You will see AI in fields like journalism, research, education, and healthcare. As a human, we carry a lot of experiences from our past, baggages, and also preconceived notions, which affects our decision-making powers. But an AI makes a practical approach to everything.
A 50% chance of AI surpassing humans, that is indeed a very interesting research. Now I would like Mitali to present her opening statement.
There is no limit to growth, as there is no limit to intelligence, as said by Ronald Reagan. What exactly is intelligence? It is the permutation and combination of various data and that we think and make our decisions accordingly. AI is just preloaded algorithms and these algorithms come from data. And where does this data come from? Humans. Everything we see around us has two aspects. One is the biological and technical one and the other is psychological one. How much ever AI can dive into our regular lives, it can never surpass the human intelligence. Intelligence, as it does not have a psychological remark.
Very well said, Mitali. Now I would like to direct the question towards Shayonika. Shayonika, how do you think AI is contributing towards a technically equipped world?
Thank you, Ananya. I'll go ahead with this saying ki, yes, we have a great opportunities in AI and examples also. I would go ahead with Siri and Alexa. As you all know ki Siri and Alexa aajkal har kisi ke ghar pe available hai. So as in our mobile devices. So we have industries coming up with AIs. We use AI in editing, journalism, media communications, and we have it personalized and user-friendly also. AI is now being used in hospitals also. They have come up with a structural develop which recognize the cognitive neurons in the brain cells. Brain is a very complex system jahan pe hame brain ke cells samajhne mein kafi difficulties hoti hai. Through the help of AI, they have started surgeries of brain, and many more complex operations are being done using the AI practices.
Very well pointed, Shayonika. AI has reached points which we can't even imagine of. In fact, IBM ka Watson naam se ek AI driven tool hai jo oncology ke liye use hota hai. Cancer patient ke treatment recommendations mein bhi use hota hai. So now I would like to go to Yash if he wants to say something.
Main Shayonika ke baat se sehmat nahi hu. AI mein creativity nahi hai. एक इंसान क्रिएटिव सोचता है, जब हम स्क्रीन प्ले लिखते हैं तो उसमें कुछ क्रिएटिविटी डालते हैं, बट एआई से जब हम पूछेंगे, हम जो उसको बताते हैं, हम जो बोलते हैं वो वही बताता है। तो हमारे इतने होनहार डायरेक्टर, आर्टिस्ट, एक्टर हैं जो एक क्रिएटिविटी पे काम करते हैं। आप एआई से कितना भी बड़ा स्क्रीन प्ले, कितना भी अच्छा स्क्रीन प्ले निकाल लो, बट जब तक एक इंसान उस पर काम नहीं करता, वो किसी भी ऑडियंस को, किसी भी व्यक्ति को वो टच नहीं करेगा। और बात आती है हॉस्पिटल की, तो जो एआई गैजेट्स हो गए या चीज़ हो गए, तो वो वही बताएंगे जितना आप उनसे पूछते हो। यदि आप किसी कैंसर के बारे में पूछ रहे हैं तो एक स्टेज पे बताएंगे कि इसको, इस व्यक्ति को इस स्टेज का कैंसर है। बट यदि एक इंसान और डॉक्टर उसकी जांच पड़ताल करता है, तो वो सारी रिपोर्ट्स को, ब्लड्स को, सेल्स को चेक करके आसपास के और खतरों को भी बता सकता है कि इस व्यक्ति को इस तरह की बीमारियां और हो सकती है या है। और यदि सारे काम, मैं एक बात कहना चाहूँगा, यदि सारे काम एआई करने लगा और आगे जाके अगर ये फ्यूचर होगा, तो अभी इतनी बेरोजगारी है, तो क्या आगे जाके बेरोजगारी और नहीं बढ़ जाएगी, क्राइम रेट नहीं बढ़ जाएंगे? एआई से कितने क्राइम बढ़ने लगे, यदि आप अखबार पढ़ते होंगे तो आपको पता चल रहा होगा कि एआई से कितने कितने ब्लैकमेलिंग और कितने फ्रॉड हो रहे हैं।
I'll come to you, Ketki, but let's first hear what Shirsendu has to say.
Thank you, Ananya. Yes, I'm not necessarily, I don't directly agree to your point. The reason being that AI is something that is still being developed. AI is a very new thing and people are still working on it. Specifically, we need to remember that AI is just a bunch of code. So it is highly customizable. You can make the AI do whatever you want. And to do this, you need coders. Therefore, actually having AI in the market actually increases jobs, unlike what people tend to think. If AI has taken away, say, 10 jobs, it is giving back at least 100.
I agree with the point that AI is giving job offers, but it giving job offers to people, like you said, coders, they're worked on the computer, like their work is related to the computer, but the common level jobs like copywriters, content writers, these jobs are taken by AI. People tend to go to AI for the caption you want for your photos or anything, but AI doesn't have a conscience that humans have. Humans have that, what is art? Art is related to emotions, and AI lack that emotions for some other reasons. And AI lacks that, that is the reason it would never will able to compete with the human intelligence. It's not like AI is not greater than human or human is not greater than AI. But the thing is, there are certain things that human tends, they have it in them, the things like experience, intuition, like your partner said about hospitals. They are doing surgeries, yes they are doing, but AI lacks communication level. वो काम कर लेगा जो आप उनको बोलोगे, आपने बोला है कि ये सर्जरी करनी है, वो कर लेंगे. वॉट अबाउट द कम्युनिकेशन लेवल? वॉट अबाउट स्पॉन्टेनियस कम्युनिकेशन? आई थिंक दैट लैक्स इन AI.
वेरी वेल पॉइंटेड केतकी. इनफैक्ट AI और इमोशंस, ये काफ़ी पुराना डिबेट है. तो शयोनिका, वुड यू लाइक टू ऐड समथिंग टू दिस?
Yes, I would like to take up this. As Ketki said, कि मुझे नहीं लगता कि talking about emotions AI नहीं कर सकता ये चीज़. AI एक ऐसा डिवाइस है जहाँ पे हम अगर डेटा उसमें फीड करेंगे तो उस चीज़ पे वर्क ऑन करना शुरू करेगा. एंड आई डू हैव एग्जांपल्स फॉर दिस. रिसेंटली दे हैव स्टार्टेड मेकिंग डेटा इनपुट्स, रीडिंग अ फेशियल एक्सप्रेशंस, वॉइस एनालिसिस एंड टोन एनालिसिस, ये सारी चीज़ों के फीचर्स धीरे धीरे इनपुट डालना शुरू कर चुके हैं. एंड इमोशंस की बात है, ड्यूरिंग एंड सर्जरीज एंड एवरीथिंग, AI डज कैप्चर इमोशंस. स्नैपचैट इज एन ऑप्शन, माई AI करके आजकल हर किसी के स्नैपचैट पे एक फीचर होता है. अगर आप उससे कुछ भी क्वेश्चंस पूछो, इमोशनल बिट, सजेशन रिगार्डिंग एनी ऑफ योर हेल्प, इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ सुसाइडल और एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ मेंटल डिप्रेशन, दे गिव्स यू कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर. वो जो गवर्नमेंट के साथ एक कोलैबोरेशन में जो नंबर्स हैं, जो इंस्टीट्यूट्स हैं जो आपको हेल्प प्रोवाइड कर सकते हैं, तो AI उस हिसाब के आपके इमोशनल बैलेंस को बैलेंस करते हुए वो उन सारी चीज़ों के सजेशंस आपको देता है, जो काफी हद तक सबको जरूरी भी है. इट्स काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग कि अगर आपको अकेलापन महसूस हो रहा है, आप उससे बात भी करो ना, वो उस हिसाब से रिस्पॉन्ड करता है. अगर आप उसे लिखते हो हे हाउ आर यू, तो वो लिखता है आई एम गुड, व्हाट अबाउट यू. यही तो चाहिए इमोशंस.
bringing in light counters to some of your points. We discussed about Snap AI. Isn't that breaching of privacy? Taking up so much of personalized information, taking up intimate information about our brains, about our emotions, what we think, what we're doing. And also, I would like to bring a few examples. First is the Google image recognition example, which was in 2015, where Google actually misconfused images of humans to gorillas. Another one is a Facebook example in which we saw that how newly enrolled Facebook users were emotionally abused or emotionally they were harmed because of the feed that they were provided by the Facebook.
To this, I would like to go back to the opening statement by your team that the AI is given the command by the humans itself. So the morphing and any destructive factor that comes after AI, the coding is given by humans. So it is not the AI that is the destructive force, it is the human itself.
Great point, Muskan. As intriguing and as interesting this discussion is, we are sadly running out of time and we need to come to an end. Before coming to an end, I would request Shayonika to give her closing statement.
थैंक यू अनन्या. यस, आई विल गो अहेड विद दिस थिंग. आज का जो डिस्कशन था हमारा एआई वर्सेस ह्यूमन इंटेलिजेंस, वी हैड बोथ द एस्पेक्ट्स एंड दोनों एस्पेक्ट्स में काफ़ी सारी चीज़ें थी, काफ़ी इंफॉर्मेशन थी सबके लिए. वन थिंग कि यस, ह्यूमन इंटेलिजेंस हैज़ कि इट लॉट अबाउट इमोशंस, क्रिएटिविटी, एनालिसिस, बट बिट बाय एआई इट कम्स विद इन डेटा एनालिसिस, ह्यूज वास्ट नंबर ऑफ डेटा एनालिसिस. And it comes up with new process and it's coming with a future. So ending this, I'll say ki yes, human intelligence is the present, but AI is the future.
Very interesting statement. Human intelligence is the present, but AI is the future. Now I would like Yash to present his closing statement.
धन्यवाद. तो जो आज हमारी चर्चा हुई artificial intelligence और human पर, तो मैं ये आपका ध्यान यहाँ ले जाना चाहूँगा कि जब हम किसी मार्केट में जाते हैं सोनार क्या और हम गोल्ड कॉइन लेते हैं, तो हम ऑब्वियसली गोल्ड कॉइन ओरिजिनल लेना चाहेंगे, ना ही आर्टिफिशियल चीज़ें उनसे मांगते हैं. तो हमारा नॉलेज, हमारी चीज़ें, हमारी जॉब आर्टिफिशियल क्यों? मैं यही बताना चाहूँगा कि 98 पर ही आर्टिफिशियल हमेशा रहेगा और इंसान हमेशा ही 100 रहेगा. और ये फ्यूचर नहीं है, 200 साल पहले ही आर्टिफिशियल ये रोबोट्स आ चुके थे. तो फ्यूचर हमेशा इंसान ही रहेगा और इंसान ही बनाएगा. तो अगर बात कही जाए तो दोनों के तालमेल से ही हम आगे बढ़ सकते हैं और अच्छे काम कर सकते हैं, बट हमेशा इंसान ही ज़्यादा ऊपर रहेगा. धन्यवाद.
Thank you to all the panelists for making this discussion productive and engaging. Man and machine are not in any race, but on a totally different track. And this journey of AI versus human intelligence will continue to evolve and have several aspects. I encourage all of you to keep pondering and engaging in discussions like these. Coming to the end of this episode, I would like to quote Raja Radhika Raman Prasad Singh ji, jinhone likha ki aakhir is pragati ke chalte humne kya kya nahi khoya aur kya kya nahi paya. Aakhir is pragati ke chalte humne kya kya nahi khoya aur kya kya nahi paya. Gyan khoya, vigyan paya. Shraddha khoi, abhigyata pai. Vishwas khoya, tark paya. Swasth khoya, ilaj paya. Aur dil khoya, to dimag paya. That's all for this episode of Students' Time. Do let us know how you like our program. You can also send your feedbacks and suggestions on our email. Our email ID is studentstime@dypiu.ac.in. I, Ananya Katti, will take your leave and we will be back soon with a fresh new episode again next time. Till then, stay tuned and think scientifically.